Hello, topic for today is hype and hoopla of hydroxychloroquine drug. Hydroxychloroquine first came into limelight in COVID-2019 phase when many prominent personalities publicly backed its successful use in treating early stage of COVID-19 infection. Many research papers were published in past 3 months with specific hypothetical thinking, which we will discuss today. Of course, these papers were not very well peer-reviewed. First, let us discuss the hypothetical role of hydroxychloroquine in the prevention of severe acute respiratory disease syndrome. 1. Acidic pH favors COVID-19 entry in the respiratory tract cells by means of its spike S glycoprotein, and hydroxychloroquine increases pH of cellular environment to alkaline side, which is not favorable for COVID-19 entry in the cells. COVID-19 enters alveolar cells through angiotensin converting enzyme 2, that is ACE2 of the cells, and it is facilitated by a serine protease as shown on the left-hand side. 2. According to the research workers' findings, hydroxychloroquine binds with ACE2 receptor, and the changed configuration of the cell receptor is then not very favorable for COVID-19 entry into the cells. 3. Hydroxychloroquine prevents binding of late formed proteins of COVID-19, and these are ORF1ab, ORF10 and ORF3A, and prevent their interaction with heme porphyrin ring of hemoglobin so that separation of large amount of free iron is prevented, which is toxic to the cells. Thus, protoporphyrin rings of hemoglobin molecules are protected with prevention of release of free iron molecules. COVID-19 infection causes excessive secretion of interferons by the immune cell stimulation, and hydroxychloroquine binds with toll-like receptor Q and prevents excessive secretion of interferons and reduces severity of cytokine storm. Well, this action of hydroxychloroquine of binding to toll-like receptor and preventing excessive secretion of cytokines is used in the control of autoimmune diseases like rheumatoid arthritis and psoriasis. Now let us see how hydroxychloroquine kills malarial parasites. Malarial parasites, when they reside in red blood cells, they attack hemoglobin molecule and separate globin and porphyrin molecules. They use globin protein and glucose molecules for their growth and break porphyrin ring and free iron, being toxic to them. Convert these free iron molecules into hemazoin crystals. Those are also called malaria pigments, as seen in on the left-hand side in the microscopic examination of stained blood smears. Hydroxychloroquine prevent formation of hemazoin crystals, and because of this action, malarial parasites are killed by the large amount of free iron molecules. Now let us see why WHO banned use of hydroxychloroquine in the treatment of COVID-19 infection. This has a reference of a research study conducted by world famous research journal Lancet. According to Lancet study, no benefits were observed of hydroxychloroquine or chloroquine with or without in combination with other antibiotics, and the study group contained 96,032 hospitalized corona patients from 671 hospitals between 28 December 2019 to 14 April 2019. Further, very important observation was by the use of hydroxychloroquine or chloroquine with or without an antibiotic was associated with an increased hazard for clinically significant occurrence of ventricular arrhythmias and increased risk of in-hospital death with COVID-19. The graph on the left-hand side indicates normal heartbeat and heartbeat in cardiac arrest. Hence, WHO has banned use of hydroxychloroquine use in the treatment of COVID-19 cases. Well, in this medical biochemistry related video, we have discussed the following points regarding the drug hydroxychloroquine. 1. Biochemistry basis of use of hydroxychloroquine in COVID-19, which are still to be peer reviewed. Then, 2. Hydroxychloroquine treatment of autoimmune diseases like rheumatoid arthritis and psoriasis on the basis of immunological principles. 3. Hydroxychloroquine treatment in malaria explained on the basis of biochemistry principles. And 4. Why WHO banned hydroxychloroquine on the basis of Lancet research paper findings. I hope you will like this video. Let me know if you have any questions, and kindly subscribe and share our educational channel. Next time, I will bring you one more educational video. Thank you very much and have a nice day.